I'm Mike Hostetler. Barbara Barr joins me with our game of the week, and this was a Lulu.
What a game, Mike. And last year, of course, Cocalico beat Manheim Central for the first time in 34 years.
Wow.
So the big question is, could they make it two times in 35 years? Well, let's go to our two field to find out. And what a game it was. Barron fans, maybe they can be eligible for the spelling bee. They might have been in shock early on, though. Cocalico leading 14-0 when Brock Gosling finds Kyle Felpel over the middle. He had a great game, 25 yards, taken down inside the 10. Couple of plays later, Nick Reitenbach bulls in from 3 yards out. The point after is blocked, but the Eagles blanking the Barons at home 20-0. Second quarter, Manheim finally gets rolling. Caleb Walton dancing in the dark, down the middle, cuts outside, and he'll go down the sidelines, 44 yards for the score. Barons on the board. They score again to cut the lead to 20-14 at the half. The Eagles looking to hold on, but it's Manheim driving again. Walton this time hits Taylor Guybe, 25 yards coming right at you, dragging a tackler into the end zone. 21-20, Manheim takes its first lead. We go to late in the fourth quarter. Eagles with a 4th-and-3 deep in their own territory. Spencer Moser busts loose. He had already scored two TDs. Looks like he'll get a third.
Will he go?
Look at that. Brendan Wagner out of nowhere makes a potentially game-saving tackle, but the Eagles line up for the field goal, which would win it. Low snap, bad conditions, of course, wet football, and Manheim survives.
Wow.
21-20, Mike. Great drama at the end, though, but what a game-saving tackle.
Looked like somebody might have got a piece of that field goal attempt, too, there at the
just
end.
Just slightly. Still made a great effort, just a little wide
oh,
right.
Oh, man, yeah. What a game.